Well, what you don't know about me is that I'm from the East Coast, I'm from Philadelphia, but I spent all my summers in Ocean City, Maryland, which is a resort town. And my dad owned a penny arcade on the Boardwalk. And so I grew up on the Boardwalk, I grew up in that penny arcade playing and also then working there. So there's a couple homes that are based on that experience. This first one is called the claw machine. I don't know what a claw machine is, where, so I love to call it a digger, where, hey, how are you? Put in some money and then you try to grab something and, you know, win some kind of prize. So, this is called the claw machine. It's got kind of neat sport. It's all kind of moving left. The claw machine. If you stand on the boardwalk and face east, you're looking into the Atlantic Ocean. If you turn south, you can see the boulders of the jetty and the sharp silhouettes of a flounder fisherman. To the north is the amusement pier, Walkerson Fries, Atlantic Taffy, the friendly gift shop, Louis Chop Suey, and the water balloon game. To the west, you stare directly into my childhood, a penny arcade with showcases of cheap gifts, rows of pokerino tables, skee-ball lanes, pinball machines. My mother sits behind the wooden cashier's booth watching customers flop quarters into the coffin-shaped game with glass sides and a moving crane. They hunch over the button, waiting for the magic moment to make three jaws stop, drop, and lock around the gift. A mustache trucker wants pink foam dice for his girl. A tourist in short sleeves wants to win his bride a beaded pink watch. The 14-year-olds have their slippery eyes on tubes of silver dollars. There are days when the game breaks down. On those days, my dad in chinos and a white undershirt crawls deep inside the claw machine and begins to monkey with the rotors. My mechanical father tapes razor blade in his mouth. Allen wrench in his hand, glasses on his head, tumor in his chest, Tyrone Power hair, ink black, slick back, tousled, bourbon, shiny with vitalis. After the shark. After the shark washed up, a man with a hammer and a man with a plank ran yelling and killed it. Upon the dulling sand, and as its brackish spasm stopped, the crowd itself began to itch. Unnerved, you have seen a shark come swimming from the sea upon the swarming land, where the bathers writhed in a basking mass, smiled at death, and each dispersed, each to a secret dream of a thing, each to personal seething. Pray to bay imagining. I would have thought the darkness of it enough to caution their ones of the waves, but they grew again, rave, within minutes of their fear, and everyone, brazenly, ran back and left, oblivious into that sea. Thanks. Okay, this poem is called Ocean City. Give me some sense of my, I can still hear the shriek of a laughing lady, the crash of a bucket of dimes, the waves against the jetty at noon. I can still see the boardwalk empty with cyclists at 8 a.m., at noon clogged with seagulls, at midnight crowded with the ghost of sleeping old people. I can still hear the whir of rusted tackle on a new marlin boat, the drip of cherry syrup onto a cone of crushed ice, the scream of teens dizzy from foam dice. I can still smell the greed of a hard sell, fresh cigar ash in the sea, the mildewed freezer in the dirty pool hall, the vinegar stink of peanut oil fries. I can still hear the sinister click of Zippo lighters, the Chesterfield voices of the Pocorino widows, the oily patter of pot-faced shills. I can still taste city lunch, where hairnet waitresses serve flounder chowder to foul-mouthed barbers, while in the alley, black men carted ice on their backs with tongs. But most shepherds locked in cages under the amusement pier. Thanks.
Yeah.